and welcome back to my channel. So today I am here with a chit chat get ready with me. It has been way too long since I have filmed a video for you guys. Probably been like 2 or 3 weeks at least since I filmed for you guys. But I wanted to make sure that I got a video up for you this week at least. It's been a crazy kind of week. I'm refilming this intro, so hopefully I'm not forgetting things. My camera decided to like stop all of a sudden, so I don't know if it got any of the intro footage or not, so it's like whatever, I'll just refilm it. So today is going to be a drugstore kind of video. I'm in the mood to do a neutral eye and a bold lip, so I thought I would do that here with you guys today, and I hope that you guys enjoy it. Again, I will be using mostly drugstore products because I feel like it. So hopefully you guys enjoy it, and I guess we'll just, you know, kind of keep going with this, and I'll kind of fill you guys in on where I've been. So I did already start, as I mentioned before, I'm not going to like pretend to put products back on. That doesn't make any sense. So I used the Maybelline Master Prime Studio for my T-zone here. And I used the Urban Decay Shadow Insurance to prime my eyes. I did not use, this is obviously not a drugstore product, but I like the e.l.f. one if you don't want to use a high-end primer or if you don't want to use a primer at all. I just noticed that when I use a primer, my eye makeup stays on a lot better. So, and now we're going to move on to eyebrows, and I'll probably kind of skip through this step for you guys, but I'm using my Anastasia Brow Wiz. There is a NYX brow thingy-ma-doo-hickey, I don't know what it's called, that I bought. But I figured I might as well just continue to use this one up. But you could definitely use the NYX. Okie dokie. So I gotta check out how I'm actually doing on time today because I actually have to go to work after this. So I guess it better look good, right? So now I'm gonna jump into my eyes just because that's kind of my routine. And I'm gonna use the Hard Candy Natural Eyes palette. It looks like this. You can get it at Walmart. I talked about this before in my last monthly favorites, and I've really been reaching for this, and I'm still reaching for it. So I'm gonna go in, and I'm gonna use some Morphe brushes. I'm gonna use the MB23, which is just like a fluffy brush, and I'm gonna go in with the lightest shade in the palette right here. I'm really only using this top row of shadows for this look. Keeping it really simple. Anyway, and I'm gonna put that all over the lid and up into the brow bone area. So anyway, so I was gonna tell you guys kind of where I've been. So as I mentioned in one of my last videos that I posted, we did have a foster kitten come and, you know, stay with us. And we were gonna be looking for him a home, and then we kind of decided after a couple of days he was just gonna stay here and live with us, and unfortunately he had some health problems and he didn't make it. So we were really, really upset about that, and you know, I felt like I needed some time. I was having a hard time, you know, kind of dealing with it all. Okay, I'm gonna go into this next brown shade. I don't have like a way to tell you, but this is the top row next to the primer, so the middle shade, but anyway. And so, you know, luckily we have our two crazy girls that we currently already have. And that was helpful in kind of getting over the process, but they're the ones that are making all that racket right now. And, so that was really hard on us. And so I'm not trying to like bring you guys down, but anyway, so I was just kind of grieving and trying to stay busy and things like that. And I just didn't feel like filming. I didn't feel like I was in a place to do that, you know, with you guys. So, as you guys can probably see, I'm just taking that middle shade and I'm just blending it into the crease here. And we got all sorts of fun noises. That is my cat dragging the toy up the stairs. Okay, I'm gonna do that on the other eye. Same thing. So yeah, I didn't feel like I was in a place to film. I've just kind of been enjoying some extra time with my husband now that he works from home. So I I took a little bit of a break, and I'm hoping to be back, you know, in the swing of things soon, but maybe not just yet. And I think I'm going to skip the Ipsy and Boxycharm unboxing this month, if you guys don't have any qualms with that. So much fun noise. Okay. So, now that that is kind of blended in, all I'm going to do now is I'm going to go back in with that same brush. This is the MB13, by the way, from Morphe. And I'm going to first go in and I'm going to pat. I'm going to use a flat shader brush. This is from BH Cosmetics, but you can use whatever you want. I'm going to go into the darkest shade on the first row right here. And I'm just going to pat that in the outer V. So, keeping this eye look very, very simple. Although I'm going to go back in with kind of an optional product here in a minute. Just because I'm me. And I can. You know me, I gotta have my shiny. So. So just patting that on the outer V. You don't have to do it very cleanly. I'm gonna go back in and clean that up in a second. So I'm gonna go back in with the MB23, which is the fluffier one, and I'm gonna blend that. That's something I want to do. So the MB13, I'm gonna blend. So. Just blend, blend, blend. So anyway, so I'm finally at a place now where I can like be okay with it and can just kind of keep moving forward and remember the good stuff. So this is turning into a really depressing video, so we're just gonna kind of move on. So yeah, so that's kind of what's been going on with me lately. And then just working a lot. I know everybody's going back to school now, so this would also be a really good look for school, for the kids going back to school. Kids, not kids, but you know, high school, teenagers, college students, you know, wanting to do something simple, because this would take me like less time if I were, you know, doing it by myself. I'm gonna go back in with that chocolate brown color just a little bit more and just kind of just swirling it on in there. So, just to make sure it's deeper. Okay. Now I'm going to go back into the brow bone shade here. Got a little flyaways, but we'll fix that up later. I'm going to go back in, and I'm going to go in with the e.l.f. It says e.l.f. contour brush, but it's like an eye contour brush. And I'm going to go back in with that lightest shade and just kind of go back under the brow bone and clean things up. Just a smidge. Because I got a little messy. Now this part is totally optional, but if you want, you can use one of the shimmery shades in the palette here. There's like two right here that you could use. And I also have a pretty gold shade, but I have a favorite. So I'm actually going to go in with a Makeup Geek shadow. These are drugstore priced, I would say. So we'll call it that. And I'm going in. These got all sorts of shifted. I dropped it and got shifted. But anyway, so I'm going to go in with the Makeup Geek shadow. It's this one right here, which I want to say is Starry-Eyed. Yeah. It's the color Starry-Eyed. I love this one. If you only buy one of them, it would be a great one. And I'm going to go in with a flat shader brush. You can use the other side of the flat shader brush that you used before. And I'm going to pat that on the lid, kind of into that inner corner. And I'll come back to it when I get, come back to it in a bit when I have finished my shadow lid. Got a little extra on there. So. Got a little crumbly on me. Okay. So I hope you guys can see this sufficiently well. Okay. And you guys are intelligent folks. You can, when I say lid increase, you guys know. You guys know what I'm talking about. So, there we go. That's that. And I want to make sure they're even. Not looking as even as I would like. So, I'm just going to go on with that fluffy brush, the MB23. And just blend some more. I don't feel adequately blended. So, back in bigger view. So I'm going to take the Rimmel Lasting Finish with Comfort Serum. It's in the red cap. I need to get a pump, but I keep forgetting. And this is in the shade 100 Ivory, which is my shade. And I just put this. First I shake it. I just put this on the back of my hand and then I use a brush. So, you don't need a ton. So it's on the back of my hand. You guys can't even see that, can you? And I'm going to go in today. I've kind of been switching back and forth between two of my different e.l.f. brushes, but I'm going to go in with the e.l.f. Ultimate Blending Brush today. And I'm going to apply my foundation that way. So, I've also been using the e.l.f. The e.l.f. blending brush, which is like a flat one. I like this one too, but I think I like this brush just a hair better. So, I don't know why, I just do. But yeah, as I mentioned, my face has been acting crazy, probably because I've been so stressed out. So, I've been using a lot of full coverage foundations lately because, well, I want to cover it up. Yeah, so it's the e.l.f. Complete Coverage Concealer, and it has four colors in it. This is obviously the light one because I'm pale. And I just mixed the darker two ones because you want to, when you're using concealer, sorry guys, I get so much help. So, anyway, I used the darker two shades because, when you are, covering up zits and things like that, you want to use just a hair darker because if you use a brightening concealer, you're going to highlight it and you don't want to do that. So, I mix the darkest two shades and just kind of pat those in. So. Can I get that redness around the nose? Do you guys get redness around your nose? I'm curious. Let me know. And I'm just using the brush that came in it. So now I'm going to go in with my under eye concealer. And I totally forgot to even use my dark circle concealer today. This is the NYX Dark Circle Concealer in Fair. It's rubbed off on the thing, but it just comes in a little pot. I forgot to use it, so I'm going to have to use it really sparingly. So, but I just put that right here. So. You have to be careful using a lot of concealers and a lot of products under your eyes because that's kind of why they crease. So if you can use less, you're better off. So if you don't have those nice pretty dark circles, then you don't have to worry about it. So then I'm going to go in with the Naked Skin Concealer. Again, this is not a drugstore product, but I really like the NYX HD concealer, so if you you can definitely use that instead. I actually prefer the NYX HD concealer, but I'm trying to use this up. So I'm trying to use it up. So yeah, I'm gonna skip Ipsy and Boxycharm this month unless you guys really want to see them. If you do, let me know in the comments and I will be more than happy to make that happen for you. I'm gonna try to still get up because I haven't got my Starbox yet, so it's still relevant. I'm gonna try to get that up for you guys still, but everybody's already pretty much posted their Ipsy and Boxycharm for the month. So, but like I said, if you guys want to see it, I'll be happy to do it. And There's also a pretty good chance I won't do monthly favorites either. It would pretty much be the exact same video as last month, so. So with that being said, of all the videos I said I'm not gonna film, which sounds like a lot, I do have an influencer Vox box coming. I got the wellness box. I have that coming for you guys here soon, which is not necessarily makeup, but more like beauty, health type items. And I have that coming for you guys. And I also, but I also want to know what you guys want to see. So let me know down in the comments kind of what videos you're interested in seeing. So moving right along. So now I'm going to go back to the eyes and I'll bring you guys back in. So first I'm going to use the Sephora waterproof eyeliner. I love this thing. It's so good. They have other good like waterproof eyeliners. You just need a brown waterproof eyeliner. But I'm using the Sephora one today. Do my upper lash line, my waterline, and then I'm going to go back in with the Jessie's Girl liquid eyeliner to do the wing and all that sort of good stuff. And again, the wing and the lashes and all that stuff are completely optional. If you like this more neutral look, then just go with it. I love this Jessie's Girl liquid liner. It's awesome. So I'm gonna try to do a wing, we'll see how that goes. It never quite ends up the way I want it to. Wings look better than I was expecting. Okie dokie. So now I'm gonna apply my mascara. I use the Flower Mascara and the Maybelline Lash Discovery, upper and lower. So you can be done here if you don't want to apply falsies, no big deal. But I'm going to apply some falsies because, I don't know, I haven't in a while and I feel like it. So I'm going to use the Oh My Lash lashes today. And these are the Kilo Minx. That's what they look like. You can see where I had to cut them. They're really pretty. I like these. I need to change pace. So I'm going to go with those today. And in case any of you guys are wondering, I use the Kiss Lash Glue. It has the little, wand applicator. So I'm going to go I'm going to go apply my falsies and I'll be right back with you guys. By some miracle, my lashes decided not to give me a fit today. So here's the completed look. So let's move on with the rest of the face. So I'm going to go in on the, continuing on the drugstore theme. Gonna go in with the City Color Sun Kiss Trio, and this is in the shade Golden, and that's what it looks like. It's picking up a little bit weird on camera, but I'm gonna go in with the bronzer first, and I'm gonna bronze up my face. I'm using the Sephora Pro Angle brush, but you don't have to. This I like these products, but they do kick up some product, so. You have to be really light-handed. So. See what I mean? They do blend pretty nicely. But if you get too much, you have to work with it a little bit. Gonna go under the chin here. Forgot to tell you what I was doing. But you guys can see. So then I'm gonna go up here. Again, I got too much. So you do really have to be careful with this so you don't look like the bronzer truck hit you. Don't wanna look like the bronzer truck smacked you in the face. Now doing. Oh, good order. So, and then I'm gonna go in with the blush in this palette, which is, it doesn't give like a specific name, but it's just like a peachier pink blush. I just cleaned off my brush and I'm using the same brush. I'm lazy. Then I'm also going to go in with the highlight, and I use the e.l.f. pointed foundation brush to apply this. Now this highlight, I like this highlight, but if you had like darker skin, this wouldn't necessarily be the right little trio for you. But it is nice and easy. I do like it. It's like the size of my face. So now that we have that done, now the final piece of the puzzle is the lips. So today I'm going to be using the Jordana Easy Liner for Lips in Sedona Red and my like new favorite of all time, Revlon Cherries in the Snow. So I'm going to apply that and then we'll show you the completed look. Sound good? Okie dokie, guys. So here's your completed look. Obviously the lashes kind of amp it up a little bit, so it's less like day wearable or whatever, but I've really been enjoying this look lately with the natural eyes and the bold lips, especially this Revlon Cherries in the Snow. Like, I know people had talked about it, but I had no idea how awesome it was. So big fan of this. So here's the completed look. I'll get you guys a little bit closer so you can kind of see. So there you have it, guys. I think it's a pretty easy look to achieve. It just looks more complicated. So let me know your thoughts in the comment box below, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Please be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and subscribe if you haven't already. And in true fashion, my hair is doing crazy things. Wouldn't be a video without it, right? So let me know your thoughts, and let me know what videos you're wanting to see now. I'm kind of starting fresh and clean with videos, so let me know what you want to see, and I will see you guys later. Bye.